Today, I'm going to teach all of you how to correct video that's been shot in portrait mode using a simple and free tool for Final Cut Pro. Coming up next on Tech Talk America. Hey folks, David A. Cox here with Tech Talk America, and if you like learning about video production, editing, special effects, or if you just want to learn how to better use your Mac, I hope you'll consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. So, I don't really do impressions, but this is what I imagine goes through the head of every video editor at every newsroom whenever they receive footage that's been shot in portrait mode. Ooh, the good news is that today I'm going to show you how to use this tool called mVertical to mirror and blur the background of your footage so that you don't have those black bars on the sides. Now, in order to use this plugin, you're first going to need to download mInstaller, which is also free. Links to both you will find down below in the description of this video, as well as a few of my other favorite little Final Cut plugins. To show you how to use mVertical, let's switch to my Mac. Even though you might think of mVertical as an effect, once you have it installed, you'll actually find it here at the top left under Titles and Generators. To initially apply it to your clip, just drag it and drop it on top of your clip, and then resize it to match its length. From here, let's go over to the inspector at the top right. If you don't have this window open, just click on this little icon over here at the top right. There are three different background modes that you can choose from: scale, mirror, and copy. In order to show you the difference between these three options, let's look at the same clip in each mode. So this is an example of scaled mode. If you look at the images on the left and right, you'll notice that it's as if we have it zoomed in on one part of this central image, and then have just applied a little blur and lowered the opacity. Here is the same shot, now in mirrored mode. And as you can see here, we have identical images on either side of the screen. Personally, this is probably my favorite of these three different effects. And finally, we have copy mode, and while this footage shows you the result of copy mode, I think you'll better understand how this image is actually being generated if I switch back to editing for just a moment, and let me just shrink the source scale, so that's the middle image, and it leaves behind, you can kind of see how this image is created. It's basically duplicating the image, and so you see part of it on the left and part of it on the right. That's basically how copy mode works. So which of those three modes do you like the best? Let me know in the poll that just appeared at the top right of your screen if you're watching me on YouTube. If this video helped you, please be sure to hit that little thumbs up like button and leave me a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.